Let's get ready to rumble!
We have had a house full of excitement here tonight. And in the weeks to come, we're going to be telling you how this great show, Nitro, is going to be coming to the Dean Dome in Chapel Hill,
coming to the
North
ring
Carolina.
This time, the Team New World Order. First, 6 feet, 2 inches, 375 pounds, from the Motor City of Detroit, Michigan. For the Steiner Recliner, the man with the largest arms in the world. Big Papa Pump, Scott Steiner! And at 7 feet, 317 pounds, from Phoenix, Arizona, considered by many to be the best professional wrestling today, the master of the powerbomb jackknife, former world heavyweight champion, Big Sexy Kevin Nash. And 6 feet, 7 inches tall, 275 and one half pounds, from Hollywood, USA, the most famous face and name in professional wrestling history. He is the leader and driving force behind the New World Order, both black and white, and Wolfpack. Ladies and gentlemen, here is United States presidential candidate and the reigning undisputed WCW NWO heavyweight champion of the world, Hollywood Hogan.
You know, guys, I kind of take issue with that. I think it is a disputed title. The fact he was handed the belt by one Kevin Nash makes it a very disputed title, but nonetheless, the excitement of, and that's quite a team right there, of Hogan, Nash, and Steiner to face the Horsemen. But the excitement of Nitro coming soon to the Dean Dome at Chapel Hill in Toronto at the brand new Air Canada Center. We're going to have more information on those events in the weeks to come.
Dallas, Texas!
Wow.
As you're out in L.A., California, I want you to know that out back, your wife is flirting with the Big Papa. Now, DDP, if your wife wants to tease me, she better be ready to please me. As I look at you physically, I know you can't satisfy your hooch, so I'm just the man to get the job done. So this goes to all my freaks out there. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me.
The Golden Girls.
And now, with the Wolfpack in the house, I'm glad that I don't see any stinking WCW or Ric Flair fans out here, because they stink real bad. A few weeks down the road, Hollywood said it, it'll be etched in stone, and it shall be done. Because it's Super Bowl, Ric Flair better hope that he has 9 lives. Because just like I beat his child in the center of the ring, just like Eric Bischoff kissed his wife, I'm gonna take Ric Flair into our world of the NWO, black, white, and red. And not only am I gonna beat him 1,000 times worse than I beat his child, I'm gonna kiss him off right out of the wrestling business, just like Bischoff did his ugly, stinking wife. Now, everybody out there knows what happens when you're not running with a pack. The big man set the standard, and if you're not running with a pack, you're hunted by the pack. So from this point on, anybody in the WCW is going to be hunted. And Ric Flair, with God as my witness, you're the first one that's going to get hunted down and torn apart by the pack. And at the hands of Hollywood in Super Brawl Flair, as I strap you over and over, you will say, yes, Mr. Hollywood, you are the man. And yes, Mr. Hollywood, you are the master. And at the end, brother, when I retain the NWO Heavyweight Championship, everybody in the world of wrestling today will say the pack that was started by Big Sexy and Scott Hall is here for life.
Pretty much summed up Hogan's feelings going into Super Brawl. If you think he's overconfident, you better think again. He feels that he's going to have a fight at Super Brawl, and we're going to have a six-man fight coming up next.